Hi, my name is Maya Grabowski. I'm 14 years old. I'm a traveler, photographer, and actor. So here's a little vlog slash review of our experience at the Royalton Riviera slash Resort in Cancun, Mexico. We did pay for to be part of Diamond Club. More on that later. So here's a little vlog slash review of our experience. So hopefully this helps. Let's start from the beginning. Once you get to the main entrance of the resort, it's another 5 minutes down to the actual resort itself. Honestly, the drive was really beautiful, and seeing the resort on the horizon for the first time is enchanting. We got there and our suitcases were taken so they could be brought up to our room. We were herded to the Diamond Club lounge, where the first little hiccup in our trip occurred. Our rooms weren't ready yet, which is fine. They told us to wait one or two hours, but much later in the afternoon, we still didn't have our room. Anyway, we finally got to our room and the swimout is amazing. If you are getting a swimout, request one on the side of the hotel because those ones tend to have more shape. Ours was right beside the waterpark, which was really convenient and also nice view. The oceanfront swimout suites, especially the ones on the higher levels, provide such a beautiful view of the landscape, but they tend to be really sunny. So if you don't like the sun too much, maybe don't take the oceanfront suite. Now, my favorite part, drumroll please, the water park. When we visited the resort, which was at the end of August, the majority of the water slides were closed. This being said, the water park does have so much to offer right now. They have racing slides for families, these two chill tube slides for those who don't really want a thrill. Then there is a super duper cool body drop slide. Super scary, but really fun in case you couldn't tell. But please wear shorts and a rash guard. Another addition to the water park that really made it stand out is the lazy river. It's super long and winds through many shady caverns designed to look like the walls are made of fake rocks. It's really nice and a super necessary break from the sun. The river only has two exits though, so plan accordingly because once you're in, you're not getting out for a while. Now let's take a walk of the grounds. They're very well kept, but I do wish there were more green spaces around the resort. Also, the resort is huge, so it can be a little bit easy to get lost. Luckily, there's a lot of awesome staff members around that will help you find your way. And once you have the layout down, you're all set. The resort has a huge, and I mean huge, main pool. It's separated into sections, but all of them are connected. There's the splash pool, where the majority of the events, like the silent party, foam party, and just a lot of parties happen. It also has a swim-up bar, cabanas you can reserve, and loungers. Usually avoid this pool because there's no cover from the sun, but it's really pretty. The Royalton slash Riviera Maya also has a area called Game Up, which has bowling, laser tag, a trampoline park, and these really cool spinning chairs, which is my favorite part. This area is exclusive to this resort. We've been to quite a few Royaltons, and this is the first time we've seen something like this. Also, it's such a wonderful place to go if it's raining, and honestly, just such a fun addition to the resort. Now let's talk about Diamond Club. So if Royalton Splash was a Mean Girls movie, Diamond Club is like the plastics. It's an exclusive club you pay for, and here's what you get for that money. With Diamond Club, you get your own little area with your own little buffet and doors to the main area. Basically, you're getting access to all the foods of the main buffet, plus your own extra buffet, and a reserved, quieter dining area for you to enjoy your morning. With Diamond Club, you also get a butler to manage your restaurant reservations, and also they're just really nice people who give super good advice. Ours were Jesus and Gabriela, and they were absolute angels. Then you have the Diamond Club Lounge, a chill little cafe-style area where you can eat, contract diabetes, have coffee. Also, you have your own private pools, plural. You literally have this beautiful stacked infinity pool that's so nice and shady in the late afternoon, and a lazy river that only Diamond Club members are allowed in. It's awesome. Diamond Club also has their own bar and own beach. On top of all this, you get a free massage / hydrotherapy session at the spa. Now, let's talk about the spa. I had the most relaxing, deep, and painful massage ever. The spa is so beautifully decorated, and it smells so good. I know that's random. Even if you're not a spa person, just go. You will not regret it. So here's a little hack. If you want to pay less, just book massage, and you get a free hydrotherapy session with that. Also, they have an on-site store with a lot of German skincare and hair care products. If you buy some stuff from there, then they let you have a free hydrotherapy session. Some other services offered at the resort include photographers, and they have the most cute, creative photos for families. Room service is offered 24/7. Housekeeping is awesome, and there is a guest services desk at the front of the building. The resort also has tennis court, fitness center, basketball courts, and soccer courts, all on the 6th floor. The fitness center has a yoga classes in the morning on the terrace overlooking the ocean. So check it out, it's really cool. There's also an amazing terrace on top of Grazzi, the Italian restaurant, and a rooftop terrace on the 9th floor. I basically live there. I love it so much, especially in the morning. Lastly, you can have a romantic dinner on the beach. Now, let's talk about the beach. I am a beach girl, but at the Royalton Splash, there's always a red flag, and people are rarely allowed to go into the ocean. This is because of a mix between dangerously dangerous waters, crocodiles and sharks that have a way of winding up near the shore, high tides, and a lot of seaweed. But obviously, you can't blame the resort for that. Blame the ocean. So now I'm going to do a quick overview of the restaurants. Gourmet Marché is the fine dining buffet. It's open for breakfast, lunch, and themed dinners, super delicious desserts, fish, and tacos. The rest of these restaurants require a reservation. Sun is the Asian cuisine teppanyaki restaurant that make food right in front of you in a spectacular, interactive show. Taj is the Indian cuisine restaurant. The Cave, which is made from local flavors and is designed to look like a beautiful cave. Everything there is delicious. Try everything. The Hunter Steakhouse for steak. Smoke, the southern style restaurant with an amazing salmon and really good walnut cakes. Grazzi, the Italian restaurant.
Agave, the delicious and beautifully decorated Mexican cuisine restaurants.
And best for last, Rio. This Brazilian cuisine restaurant literally brings the food to you and it's amazing. Take a bit of everything because I didn't like beef until I tried theirs. Also, the grilled pineapple is amazing. I'm at a loss for words. It's amazing. Anyway, now it's time for the final rating. The resort is a 4 out of 5 stars for me. It's an amazing experience, but it's not the type of resort I'd want to return to. I hate this part, but we have to do it. So here are all the main cons from the resort. On the con side, the beach was not beaching how I wanted it to beach. The layout was tiring and confusing. The water park wasn't complete. The main pool had a lack of shade. On the pro side, yes, I love this part. The food was absolutely amazing. Not only the restaurants, but the Scoops Ice Cream Shack, the Grazzi to Go station that offered pizza by the water park, the many food trucks, and the Nibbles mini buffet by the pool. The swimouts are amazing. The staff are so wonderful. The drinks were good. The drinks were really good. Sorry, I have a mocktail obsession and had to add that in. The Diamond Club beach / pools were really cool. I loved the terraces, and the entertainment at the resort was on point, even when it was raining. Also, the gift shop is gorgeous. So if you're thinking of visiting Cancun and exploring Mexico, Royalton Splash is definitely a good option. But maybe not the best one for people who like the beach. But it's really family friendly and really good for families. Also, it's quite far from famous excursions like Xcaret, Playa del Carmen, Tulum, etc. We had to take an hour-long drive to Playa del Carmen, which was fine for us, but maybe not for younger children. Honestly, I really enjoy the resort. It's super relaxing, and I don't regret it at all.
If you've been to the Royalton Riviera Splash, then please leave your thoughts in the comment section. And keep in mind that this video is just an opinion. I hope this video helped you decide if this is the right resort for you. Sending lots of love. Thank you so much for watching this video.
Sincerely, Maya. You know.